Oh, hello friends, I'm Paulshinn. This is the YouTube channel Making Model A's Cool Again. And by the way, this video is kind of momentous because this is the 200th Ford Model A video that I've recorded. Now, the way release dates and things work, it may not be the 200th released to YouTube, but it is definitely the 200th video that I've recorded about Ford Model A's. Wow. Thank you so much for joining me on this tremendous journey to make Model A's cool again. So I kind of failed a little bit and I owe you an apology. I thought all this time that I had recorded a video showing how to adjust a Ford Model A clutch. Turns out, apparently I did not. So today I'm going to fix that. Although a Model A clutch can easily be adjusted just laying on the garage floor, I'm going to go ahead and put it up on the lift, and I have put it slightly off-center of the lift so that you can get a really good view of what's happening. So basically, the Model A clutch, the way it works is you're supposed to have about an inch or two of play in it, which means nothing really happens until the spring hits, and then it's supposed to be all spring after that. You should have your release somewhere near the top, not right off the floor. If it releases right off the floor, you definitely need to adjust your clutch. Let me show you how this one works. Okay, with the engine running, the brake is on. I've got the safety plates in place so the car won't roll off the lift, and the lift is still at ground level. I just want to show you where the clutch works. If you can see here where my blue shoe is, I'm going to put it in reverse. Now there's nothing. And then right there, that's where it starts to grab. Okay, that is about that far from the top. Okay, so this is pretty close to adjustment, but I think it could use just a little bit more. And since this car is going to a new home, I want to make sure it's perfect when it leaves here. So let's get to adjusting. Welcome to the underbelly of my two-door sedan, where safety is the highest priority. So here you can see where the brake and the clutch pedals mount right here. And right here is the linkage for the clutch. So this obviously being the clutch housing, this little arm right here, this shaft is what connects to the forks that push the clutch forward and let it go backwards. And that pedal, when you push the pedal down, see how it pulls up on this? It pulls up, that turns that shaft that way, pushes those forks forward. That's how the whole thing works. As you can see right now, there's a little bit of play in it. I'm going to go ahead and take this cotter pin out, take that pin out, and show you what a lot of play looks like. Ah, finally. Okay. So I'm gonna push up on the clutch release lever and pull this pin out, there. So now the clutch pedal's loose, and so is this. Now you can see here, there's a lot of play in that, and here's where the clutch grabs, and you can even kind of hear right where the clutch grabs. So what I need to do is turn this, this is called a trunnion right here, so I need to turn this inward, so screw it in to pull some of that slack out, okay? So here's where it was, so I'm just gonna give it two little turns like that. That's all it's gonna take. This one wasn't that far out. Now comes the hard part. You really gotta push this up, push that down. It helps if you have two people. I'm gonna try and do this where you can see too. Okay, if I do this right, it should go in. It's a lot harder than it looks, people. Ah, there, got it. All right, now how much play do we got? There we go. You can hear that it's not touching, so we don't want the forks pushing against the throwout bearing all the time. That'll wear out the throwout bearing. We just want just a little bit of play. That's perfect. That's what we want. So, let's throw a cotter pin in it. Mr. Cotter, Mr. Cotter. There we go. Make sure your cotter pin does not go all the way through. That one does not, so that's good. All right, I cheat a little bit and I turn my cotter pin sideways on these to get them started. Once it starts, I'll put it the right direction, then bend both sides of it up. Then I get my cutters out and make it the correct length on both sides, which is right about, I don't know, about there. Like so. And then so it doesn't grab stuff when I'm down here cleaning the car, I just bend the ends up so they're nice and out of the way. Ta-da! Done. Since that adjustment is utter perfection, now is the time to just hit this with a little bit of grease to make sure it's good and lubed. Grease the two pedals. Not all Model A's have these grease fittings. If you don't, use an oiler. I'm going to use the oiler in just a second to make sure that the rest of the clutch linkage is well lubed. Because if you wear out that clutch arm right there, it is a pain, and it always happens on the side of the road. So just a couple drops of oil is all it takes there. One up here on the trunnion. That's it. And if you don't have the grease fittings, just put oil right up here, top of the pedals, let it drip in. Let's get this thing down off the lift. Take it for a test drive. Might be my last time driving this car. Oh, that seems weird. So now there is just about 1 inch of free play in the clutch pedal, and it's all business after that. So let's see how it feels with the engine running. Okay. Right there. Oh, that's perfect. That's about 2/3 up off the floor. Oh, I forgot to turn the gas on. Oops. Yes, it happens to everyone. All right, let's go for a ride. So there you are, friends. Real simple clutch adjustment. I'm sorry I didn't do it sooner. I'm glad we finally did get to it. And celebrating 200 Ford Model A videos. So Model T was over at Harbor Freight and bought this for me as a gift celebrating 200 videos. This is a drone with a camera in it. And although some of you may know, I'm a pretty accomplished RC pilot. In fact, I used to compete in Pattern and IMAC pretty competitively. I flew radio control ever since I was seven-ish, eight-ish maybe. So I'm really accomplished with that. Not so good at drones, never flown one before, but I'm gonna try seeing if I can get some good shots with this. Maybe some future videos will have some drone shots of cars or something. I don't know, or maybe just me crashing. I don't know, let's find out. Thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to see you on video number 201. Thank you so much.